Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the Super Producer series, which is where we learn from the producers who are just killing it. Today we're going to focus on Kenny Beats. Kenny Beats is one of those producers where you like a lot of songs and then you look at who produced it and it's all the same person. He's one of those producers who you always get magnetized to just from his sound alone and the artist he decides to work with. So he has a really good YouTube channel, hilarious YouTube channel. Where he brings artists into the studio, he makes beats with them, and then they make like a freestyle to the beat, and it's a funny YouTube. I'll leave the links below to his channel, but hilarious. And he understands it. He's a content creator on top of a great producer. That's what you have to be in today's world, and he gets it. So shout out to Kenny Beats. Today we're gonna focus on his 808 sound. He has a very specific 808 sound because he realizes the importance of bass in hip hop. It's like everything. So that's one thing that's consistent between all his records. Now, he has a lot of moving parts. He likes to use samples sometimes. And just really, his style changes over time. I mean, if you look and listen to his tracks with Rico Nasty, you'll hear how his style can change. So he's a very well-versed producer. He's not just a one-style type of producer. But one thing I've noticed is his 808 selection. So let's grab the 808 Science drums. All the top pros use these 808s. So let's skip to one. And I'll show you how he may process is 808. So let's grab this one for now. And I need something with a little bit more of a body characteristic. I have to shut up so I can hear the actual sound. Hold on. So some of these are already processed. Well, they're all processed, but some of these already have a vibe and you don't want to overdo it. So one thing with 808s, again, I'm gonna like be short about it because we can go on for days and days trying to get the perfect sound. But his 808s, the one specific thing is he goes to the envelope tab and he uses hold parameter, which means when I let go of the key, it stops. And that's important for our genre, our modern genre, because it depends on the song, but you don't want the 808 to ring out the whole way all the time. So the way he gets those tight grooves is by using that hold parameter. Now the other trick is to send, so right click and route to this track, which creates a send, a duplicate of the first track, sending it to a second track. Now I'm doing a send because I want to hear what it sounds like versus direct processing. Let's load up any saturator plugin. You may have Sausage Fattener, you may have PSP or P, I know it's not PCP, whatever that vintage warmer plugin's called from a while ago. You may have, you know, Fruity Blood Overdrive. You may have the Bus plugin from Ableton. Whatever your plugin of choice is for saturation, grab that. You may have Isotope. Let's grab the Culture Vulture. This is just my favorite sound. And now when I play the 808, it's going directly through this and I can drive this harder and it won't take away from our original sound. And also what I'm gonna do here is group both of these sounds into one. How can I do this though? I have to send a duplicate of here to here and then I have to send this to, I guess the way we would do that is send it here, manually call this a group. Now this should work. So both these sounds should be grouped here. I'm gonna add a Fruity Soft Clipper just so we don't like clip, just for leveling sake. Okay, so now let's really push the Thermionic Culture Vulture. You can use any saturation plugin. There's so many out there. Okay, so now you can hear that grime in the bass. And now the 808 starts to come alive without ruining the characteristics of the original 808. So you're blending distorted 808 with original 808. Or you can do direct, but the thing about direct is that you lose some bass sometimes if you distort it too much. So that's how you blend distortion. Now you can push it even harder with the volume knobs. I like prime, but let me see what Nuke sounds like. Nuke has that kind of bubbly tone you need because it's a pulse wave based 808. But to get the meat out of it, you'd have to use higher octaves. So really, the Electron is also good for this stuff. Okay, so hear that. So if I turn off the, here's just what it sounds like normally. Now here's with the double voice. So that's how you get that vibe going. It's called parallel processing. Doesn't mean you have to compress all the time. But one more Thing You Want to Do. Chances are, I've heard this a lot in one of his records. I forget what record. I think it's a Rico Nasty record. Forgive me, but it sounds like a distressor compressor. Okay. I learned this from my mentor. It just makes stuff feel tamed. So where are we going? Distressor by, who's Distressor by? I always forget. Imperial. Okay, here we go. Empirical Labs. So this is a demo version. I need to buy it because this is, if there's like one UAD plugin that I'd suggest, a Distressor is definitely one. It's on that top five list. So what it's doing is just taming the signal. I know we're getting a little advanced into mixing, but all it's doing is just making sure the 808 stays in its zone, basically. So let's use 808 Electron. I like this one. And let's go to about 148 BPM. Actually, let's do 144. Let's do the esoteric tempos. And let's start the beat with just the 808. Just middle C. We don't have to do anything crazy here. It's all about the vibe. It's all about being cool. So boom. Boom, 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 boom. 1 thing you could do is throw it a little bit with a little time shift. Just a little bit behind the metronome. Just so it swings a little bit. It creates a cool feel. Three, four, one, two, three, boom. So I have to add a note just so it lets the loop go. Boom, boom, boom. So, I mean, this is where you add your own style, but this is his technique. Let's get the level a little bit higher. So I'm going to copy the whole thing over. Now you can distort it a little bit more than I did. Let's just see what overdrive sounds like. If you really want to take it further, turn on overdrive on this plugin. Now what it does is it takes the lower tones and now makes them higher tones. So you got to be careful here. Because you can easily make it too thin and it's too distorted. So that's where we get into that Ronnie J zone. You just want enough drive. And let's pull it back down. Just where you get that rumble. And that's like the sweet spot, in my opinion. So notice the length of the 808, the length of the note determines the sounding of the 808. So we're trying to make it cut off. So right here, I want to cut it off. So let's hit Alt left click to create a gap, and you'll hear the gap. Actually, instead of this gap, hitting Alt L for those in FL Studio. What I want to do is add this over here, but then leave a gap, which the gap will be the beginning of the beat, so you'll hear it. You heard it right here. So it throws the listener off. Okay, so now it's like that stop and go feel. It feels like a sample, and that's what's being reintroduced in hip-hop, is stuff feeling like a sample. They can drive it way harder. Again, it depends on the 808. I think for this one, 808 Electron has the tone that I want. Now we can spend all day trying to get subtones and all this, but I'm not gonna obsess. Let's go to song mode. Now a lot of his stuff has like a sampled feel to it, and he leaves a lot of space in his beats. So another thing is he uses steady hi-hats in the songs that I'm referencing. So let's go to the Ultimate Producer Bundle at busyworksbeats.com. Let's find our clap that almost every hip-hop track uses, because it just works. Let's add this on the 3 and the 7. Now his rhythms can be tight, but very fast. So he uses a lot of percussion if he's gonna go that route. Now, again, for the clap, let's use our envelope and shorten the clap. We go over this in Drum Magic. Curtis King shows you techniques like this, how to make your drum sound tighter. Like literally tighter, not just like metaphorically tighter. Let's see what else we got here. So we need to stretch some audio. So this is why I like to have friends who create samples and loops, okay, that are royalty free. let's go to soundoracle.net, because it's a difference in creating MIDI in a plugin and creating a melody versus time stretching something that's already been done. It sounds completely different. Let's go to soundoracle.net. They just released some new packs. I got to get them. Just haven't checked out on the checkout yet. So let's use something I already have. I'm looking for a melody loop or some kind of melodic loop. I also want to look at the vocal section, but let me look at some stuff. So XO2 I know has melodic loops. They're more for R&B, but I can blend it in here. Let's go to audio files. I want to work with audio because you can time stretch it differently. And Kenny beat stuff is very subtle, like this would be. Electrocuted gremlins, okay. Let me see what this sounds like slowed down. I just want to hear what it sounds like, because that'd be interesting. Let's run it through halftime. Okay, it's a little grittier than I thought in halftime, but I would definitely have to run something like that through halftime. We need something just like this, like very belly, very lightweight. Let's grab this, drag it in. So the fact that it's audio, you can do a lot with, and people don't understand the importance of audio. You can cut audio, so no matter how much reverb a sound has, you can immediately cut it off and it will stop. Whereas if you have MIDI and then your reverb is on, you can't just stop the MIDI, the reverb, unless you do a bunch of automation. So first thing we need to do is time stretch. So I believe this, let me count the bars on this sample. 1, 2, turn the volume off. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, 1, 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4, and. So here's the transient. Let's cut it right at the transient. We're close enough. Delete that. Now I sample in the playlist. I don't know why I used to sample in the channel rack. That used to take up so much time. Go to time stretch mode, hit Alt, left click, drag it so it matches. And now it's time stretch. Go to your channel settings, go to mode and go to stretch mode so it keeps the same pitch. See how it feels like stretched out and like you're waiting. It's building anticipation because it has a different sound than if you just play this in a plugin. Run this through. Oh, not halftime. Let's drive the 808 a little bit more. I'm gonna push the volume here. Make sure we're not going nuts with the volume. Let's add a soft clipper. You can see at a certain point it just starts becoming very buzzy instead of like boomy, shaky. So the 808s are, you really have to sit with them, but I'm going to drive the 808. I just want to see how hard we can push the 808. Also, it's a little detuned, it's a little sharp. Let's pull it down. So I'm just turning up the drive a little bit and then pulling back the original. There we go, now we're getting it. Let's just crank it up just to see what it sounds like. Hear that buzz. Now we don't need it that hard. I just want to hear what it sounds like. That's just a hard 808. Man, I would push it that hard, but I'll be safe here. Let's also run an EQ. Boost up that low end just a little bit. Let's do the EQ before the compressor, just so it has more jumbled up information. But you don't have to let the sample run all the way through. You can use the slice tool. And here I'll show you a trick. Hit shift, left click, like every bar. Let's duplicate all these chops over, hit control B. Make sure it's perfectly time stretched. Actually, instead of doing, see that little gap at the end? That's because I didn't time stretch it perfectly. We're going to hit shift left click because there could be gaps. I don't want to get into everything about everything, but that's why. Now use your slip tool. Go to snap to grid bar. And to change it up over time, you can left click and drag that section. Just to change it up so it's not the same thing over and over again. So that way it feels like you're just randomly chopping. Crank the BPM up a little bit. Also, Kenny Beats put me on to All Black, who's a really good rapper in my opinion. Cue to Fool, I like a couple songs of his. Crazy, it's crazy, you know ain't with us. What else did he put me on to? I don't know. Rico Nasty, I've heard of her before, but he made her come out alive, I think. Let's see what else we can add here. So his beats are very minimalistic, but it's all about having that tempo that's cool enough to let the 808 rock. Let's cut out some of the highs though. Pitch the 808 down a bit. Because when you start saturating a sound, it can sound out of tune. So just be careful. Okay, now let's add that bounce. We can still add melodic stuff. But let me add the bounce now, and then we can go back to the melodic stuff. Let me add Fruity Reverb 2. Just want to hear what it sounds like. Now he doesn't use a lot of reverb like that. I just wanted to see what it would sound like. Also, he uses sound effects. Like, he'll just use, like, the most random stuff. These are for R&B tracks. If you're wondering why those are. Let's add this in. Let's just pitch it. Oh. To where it's like boom. We're gonna go to the master pitch here. Pull it down 100 cents at a time. Let's run it through full reverb, 100% wet level, turn the dry level down. It's a different key, so. That's making it clash too much. But you gotta try that stuff. Anyway, let's grab a hi-hat, simple hi-hat. Try one thing, pull the 808 down an octave. That's too low. It's a balance, though. You got to be careful with the drive because it can sound too thin because you're pushing it too hard. So it's always that balance. Also, I don't like how that 808 just stops. One, two, three, four. And it's really about the artist he works with. It depends. He can go outside of the trap box. He doesn't always just do simple trap stuff. But it's all about that 808. But you see how complex the 808 can get. Let's switch out the distortion type. Let's try this one. Gives us a little more of a different sound. I like this distortion style, it's different. Of course, it's starting to storm right when I go in. Let's add some vocals. It's hard to make videos during the summer because it rains so much. Let's add some vocals from Sound Oracle's Articulate. So I'm just going to play it as if it were a song. Use that hold parameter. That's the trick. Now this is my own touch. I'm not going to... Let's record. I'm not going to time stretch it or anything. Something here. I just want to time stretch it in the actual sampler. So let's just left click and drag it up. Ooh, sounds weird. Let's go to mode, stretch mode, and let's pull it up. There's one note that's not in the key, so I'm trying to like avoid it. Kind of like the regular, but let's see what negative 500 sounds like. Let me copy this. I mean, clone it. Copy, paste the same thing. And one's going to be regular, one's going to be... We're going to pan one left, one right. And I'm going to give them a small time difference so they don't sound at the same time. It's all about having that weird, cool thing about your beat. And I think Kenny Beats nails that up every single time. Let's create an effect send for the vocal thing and just get weird with the effects. It's raining super hard to finish this video before anything happens. Let me make sure our recorder's still going here. We're good on the recorder. Is my face moving? Let me check. Gotta check. Let's see. Check. Bye bye. Okay. Making sure we're all good because you never know. So let's start with reverb. So I told you I'm gonna get weird. This is where I get weird with my effects. Pull tech. Now it's probably the compressor, but let me see. Pull tech. Where are we at? I can't read today. Let's boost at 100. Let's also watch and see the distress is overly working, so I need to pull back the input, lower the output, just so we don't blow our ears out. Solo. That's weird. Oh, the output. Duh. So you can see how complex mixing 808s can be. So now we have the boom and we have the distortion without like one being louder than the other. You can use Isotope Trash for distortion. There's all types of distortion plugins out there. Waves GTR. Let's get weird though. Turn your wet level up, dry level down. Use your time modulation. This is gonna create a pitch wobble. But against the original, it's gonna make it sound like a chorus. So it's like chorused reverb. Now let's add delay on top of that. Keep the dry level where it is, wet level somewhere, and I'm gonna cut out the frequencies, create a ping pong effect. So it's throwing the reverb back. Alexa here and that bounce. When that kick came in, man, the kick just added so much punch. Shout out to the kick. And this is right from the Ultimate Producer Bundle. It shows how far you can push this kick. All you got to do is add a Fruity Soft clipper, turn the threshold up, turn your fader down a little bit, and just crank every volume knob for your kick, and it will smack your speaker so hard. Trying to match the 808 on that second time around. So it's important the kicks match the 808 for the majority of it. You feel like they're in unison. So I'm using that bongo as a... That's some rim shots. Put it. Two, three, put it. Just little small bounces here and there. You don't gotta overkill it. Let me change that one 808. This goes boom. Could be because it kind of throws off the bat. Now here's where I'm adding my own finesse. That's just my own style. I mean, you don't have to do all that. But it's important to kick matches, so let's make that unique. Never mind, because it throws off the pattern too much. Also, it's too high. No, never mind. It was a good thought, but it wasn't. It just wasn't on. It's better. like, and you don't have to use the thermionic culture vulture. You can use something like Isotopes Exciter. This is my favorite for just getting that 808 to really rumble. In the low end, just use triode mode and just stay in your low frequencies. You can expand these though. Only thing, it just doesn't give enough drive. So what we're gonna do, but it's a lot cleaner though. It feels really smooth because you have two 808s, remember. Let's crank up the output so we can smack the Fruity Soft Clipper. Now we have like a softer distortion sound. Let's keep cranking it. There we go. Now we have our own distortion without using any distortion plugins. This is really the compressor that you're hearing. Fruity Soft Clipper. You don't want to overly go into the distressor and make it overly work because it'll take away the signal. But now let's just level it. So I like this sound better than the, you can see how far we've come though with the 808. This needs a little drive. So I may use Thermion Culture Vulture, but turn the mix level way, way down. Because it gets too, like, rattly. I don't want it to get too buzzy. Like there, the 808 should have been more active, so let's do something with the 808 here. Really unique 808 sound. I mean, the hi-hat's simple, the bounce, those little percussion elements are really important. But those things. And it's really about the artist at this point. You can level the 808 so it's not super loud against the kick. But in all his records, the 808 and kick are like the main part of the show, and then it's the vocals and then everything else. Let's see if halftime would add anything to that. Probably not, but let's just try. Adds like a, I like that. Adds like a weirdness to it that I like. Let's EQ out the low end on these vocals if there isn't. Like attitude in my voice. Let me see if I can do it. Hold on. Up close and personal, right? I don't know her tone, but she up close and personal. Every time I breathe, well done. That's how she does. Scratchy voice. Let me see if I hear a hook in my head. Definitely gonna need auto tune for whatever. So let's find the key. Might as well show you how to add a vocal. since we've come this far. Shout out to Kenny Beats though again. Project Info, we've been on this for about a half an hour. Might as well add vocals. Might as well finish it out. So everything except B. It's going to auto-tune. We're at 440 hertz tuning. I'm gonna turn flex tune up. Zero retune speed. This is just my favorite setting. So we're playing all the white notes except for B. We're playing A sharp. So here's our key. So let me just kind of like mumble to myself until I come up with something. Again, all his artists are more rappers than not like singers, but let's try it. I mean, all the artists I know. Except Q the Fool. You know it's a Josh. You know you ain't f***ing with us. Loop recording. I have to see how quick it fixes my voice. All right. Diamonds on the wrist. You ain't got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit. Reverb on that. Let's see what it sounds like. Diamonds on the wrist. Cuban got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit. Ooh. Diamonds on the wrist. Cuban got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit. Ooh. Diamonds on the wrist. Cuban got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit. So now I'm going to do ad-lib. Let's try that. Diamonds on the wrist. Cuban got the fit. And I'm on my shit. Tell if I was in key or out key. I couldn't really hear myself. Let's try it again. Diamonds on the wrist. Cuban got the fit. And I'm on my shit. Ooh. Diamonds on my wrist. Can I hit a lick? Can I hit a flip? Ooh. Diamonds on my wrist. I did not exist. All I do is flip. Ooh. Honey with a brick. All I do is whip. All I do is whip. So I'm going that Rico Nasty / singer route, whatever that means. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit, and I'm on my shit.
Diamonds on my wrist, I did not exist, all I do is flip.
Listen, let me get a topic before I just go in. When I freestyle, I have to have at least a topic. I couldn't think of anything. I was overly thinking. Man, I hit a flip. Ooh, yeah, diamonds on my wrist. I did not exist. All I do is flip. Ooh, put it with a brick. All I do is whip. Let me do harmonies. Diamonds on my wrist. I forgot what I said. Diamonds on my wrist. Whatever. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fist, man, I'm on my shit, ooh. Diamonds on my wrist, can I hit a lick, man, I hit a flip, ooh. Yeah, diamonds on my wrist, I did not exist, all I do is flip, ooh. Honey with a brick, all I do is whip, all I do is whip, yeah. So you gotta, like, harmonize. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. So usually I wouldn't route everything to one track. Diamonds on, but for this. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit. I think it's more distracting, let me see. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. The thing is, because I didn't know the words, so it's more distracting than helpful. If I had words written, it would make more sense. Anyway, let's continue. I just have to think of a topic. I can't think though. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit, man, I'm on my shit. Ooh, diamonds on my wrist, can I hit a lick? Man, I hit a flip. Ooh, yeah, diamonds on my wrist, I did not exist. All I do is flip.
For a turbo, I'd have got a lot of ass turbos. Go to tank and gas, I had to get to the mall.
Man, let me think of a topic. I need like a general topic, like struggle, something. It's right on the tip of my tongue. I just can't think of what I would talk about.
All I do is whip. All I do is whip.
That's what I'm gonna start with. Hopping out the car, I'm
like, yeah, honey with a brick, yeah. All I do is whip, yeah. All I do is whip, yeah. Hopping out the car, I'm like, yeah, baby, come on. Is we riding out, or is we gonna stall out? Wrist and guns and all, just in case you try to ball out. Diamond on my wrist, and them diamonds never fall out. Can I get you on if you're talking to a baller? Big bank roller, you know. All about the fucking dollar. Cash rules everything around me. Wu-Tang. Shout out to my girl, and she knows she is my boo.
I ran out of breath. Oh my god, I'm choking up. Man, I was on a decent rhyme scheme, but I got choked up.
Whip, yeah. All I do is whip, yeah. Hopping out the car. Whip, yeah. Hopping out the car. I'm like, yeah, baby, come on. Is we riding out, or is we gonna start out? Cause no, just in case you try to ball out. Diamond on my wrist and them diamonds never fall out. Can I get you on if you're talking to a baller? Big bank whip.
I'll just continue. I'll do ad-libs. This track's kind of fun. Shout out to Kenny Beats one time. Actually, a lot of times. Shout out to Kenny Beats a lot of times. Let's do ad-lib.
Yeah, honey with a brick. Yeah, all I do is whip. Yeah, all I do is whip. Yeah, hopping out the car, I'm like, yeah, baby, come on. Is we riding out, or is we gonna stall out? Wrist and guns and all, just in case you try to ball out. Diamond on my wrist, and them diamonds never fall out. Can I get you on if you're talking to a baller? Big bank roller, you know, big baller. Shouts that I got it, and I don't like getting a dollar. When I run up, bitch, it's all about the fucking dollar. Cash rules everything around me. Shout out to my girl, and she knows she is my boo.
bars, but it should be enough. Yeah, honey, lay the brick, yeah. All I do is whip, yeah. All I do is whip, yeah. Yeah, hopping at the car, I'm like, yeah, baby, come on. Is we riding out, or is we gonna stall out? Wrist it, cousin, no, just in case you tryna ball out. Diamond on my wrist, and them diamonds never fall out. Can I get you on if you're talking to a baller? Big bank roller, you know, big baller. Shouts that I got it, and I dunk like a dollar. When I run up, bitches, all about the fucking dollar. Cash rules everything around me, Wu-Tang. Shout out to my girl, and she knows she is my boo. You know, big dollar. Shouts that I got it, and I dunk like a dollar. When I run up, bitches, all about the fucking dollar. Yeah. Cash rules everything around me. Wu-Tang. Shout out to my girl, and she knows she is my boo. When I hit the Danny, man, I'm stunning all my enemies are drowning me. When I hit the bar, I'm tryna drown in me. Henny out the bottle got me frowning. Around in me, pull out 100 clip pounding me. So what I'm doing is rerouting the ad lib. Big bank roller. So I have to identify the ad lib.
Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. Ooh, man, I'm on. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. Ooh, man, I'm on my shit. Flip, ooh, honey with a brick.
do is whip, yeah. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit, man, I'm on my shit.
I let the beat ride. We didn't add any mastering or anything. This is a rough mix. I didn't stereo image anything or do anything crazy. But you can see it's all, oh, I forgot to add auto-tune on. I feel like that guy was, you can see that. It's all about getting your level super hard before you do all that extra stuff. So that is it. But I'm going to play it like three times through. I left the beat open at the end just so you could hear the beat.
Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit, man, I'm on my shit, ooh. Diamonds on my wrist, can I hit a lick, man, I hit a flip, ooh. Diamonds on my wrist, I did not exist, all I do is flip, ooh. Honey with a brick, all I do is whip, all I do is whip, yeah. Hopping at the car, I'm like, yeah, baby, come on. Is we riding out or is we gonna start out? Wrist it cousin all just in case you tryna fall out. Diamond on my wrist and them diamonds never fall out. Can I get you on if you're talking to a baller? Big bank roller, you know big dollar. Shots that I got it and I don't like a dollar. When I run up, bitch, it's all about the fucking dollar. Cash rules everything around me, Wu-Tang. Shout out to my girl and she knows she is my boo. I'm standing on my enemies are drowning me. When I hit the bar, I'm trying to drown in me. Hitty out the bottle, got me frowning me. About to hop in my car, rounding me. Pull out 100 clip, pounding me, yeah. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit. Do is whip.
I'm like, yeah, baby, come on. Is we riding out or is we gonna start out? Wrist a cousin, no, just in case you tryna ball out. Diamond on my wrist and them diamonds never fall out. Can I get you on if you're talking to a baller? Big bank roller, you know, big dollar. Shouts that I got it and I don't like a dollar. When I run up, bitch, it's all about the fucking dollar. Cash rules everything around me, Wu-Tang. Shout out to my girl and she knows she is my boo. When I hit the down in me, I'm stunning all my enemies are drowning me. When I hit the bar, I'm trying to drown in me. Hitty out the bottle, got me frowning me. About to hop in my car, rounding me. Pull up 100 clip, pounding me, yeah. Diamonds on the wrist, Cuban got the fit. Man, I'm on my shit.
Super hard. Shout out to Kenny Beats. Learned so much from you. I always find it being that like he's the producer of all the tracks that I find myself liking. So shout out to Kenny Beats once, actually a lot of times. I'll leave his link below for his YouTube channel. And thanks for watching. And a funny video, actually. Shout out to him again for the 18th time. It's BusyWorksBeats.com. If you want to learn more, join now as a premium member at BusyWorksBeats.com/premium. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.